What do an ex-basketball playing movie star, the England's manager's ex-bit on the side, and a plastic surgery obsessed pop icon have in common? They're all at your mercy tonight. Hello, hello, hello. And welcome to the second eviction night of Celebrity Big Brother 2006. Oh, guys, please, honestly, Dad dancing reached new levels of cringe at Preston's birthday this week when the cat daddy himself, George, twisted on down. So embarrassing. And poor Ruler got very, very, very upset with Big Brother for playing fanfare music when she took off her pants. Personally, I don't know what the problem was. I always have music playing when I take mine off.
Hands of power!
Don't know what the problem is. OK, tonight, it's time for you to put another celebrity out of their misery. To evict Dennis, call 09011 32 3302. That's 09011 32 3302. To evict Faria, call 09011 32 3303. That's 09011 32 3303. To evict Pete, call 09011 32 3308. That's 09011 32 3308. Or you can text the name of the housemate you want to evict to 844-44. Lines are going to close in 29 minutes, but right now, it's time to watch the first instalment of yesterday's action. And can I just ask you all, please, this is so amazing, this bit of telly, it's so cringeworthy. Ruler and George, if you're going to bitch about someone, just try and make sure they're not in the room.
Dear 13, 8:01 a.m. Big Brother has gathered the housemates in the living room to announce the results of yesterday's nominations.
OK, let's each of us take a pledge to wail inconsolably.
Wail inconsolably?
Yeah, like...
After wearing the pants of power for 3 days, Big Brother told Ruler she must nominate one additional housemate to automatically face the public vote. She nominated Pete.
This is Big Brother.
Well, she goes now.
The housemates nominated for eviction this week are, in alphabetical order, Dennis and Faria and Pete.
How's about that then? Okay, onwards and upwards. On we go.
Oh, dear.
Wait, are we missing a house guest?
No. I'm second time around, I'm in the lead.
I'm going back.
Don't throw yourself on the floor.
Yeah, I'm confused.
Your public loves you.
I couldn't throw myself on the floor. I'm like an old lady when I wake up in the morning.
An old pro, innit? More ways than one.
I'm an old prostitute.
...10:01 a.m. Faria and Dennis are in the living room. Ruler, George and Tracy are in the bedroom.
But she's a wise lady, Faria. I like her.
I like her too. I'm not sure that wise is the word I'd use. I don't think somebody who's rebounding from an affair with the England manager and now running around with Dennis, I don't think that counts as wise.
Dennis, I don't get the hang of at all. Once or twice he's seriously come to life, but both him and Tracy, for me, are on a different planet. Mm. You know, they're not...
Not engaged at all.
Tracy, I can't...
Can't work her out.
...have any sort of conversation of, ah, thank you so much. You know, that's the only level. Even though I've tried a bit, but there's just no communication level. And Dennis, unless it's sexual or unless it's I told you this was going to happen,
Didn't say
not much else either.
Hi. I don't mean to interrupt, but I'm going to. I don't care. I have to say something. I was sleeping, but I needed to sleep because I'm just getting off the blob. As I was coming out, I heard Rula talking. All I heard was, I've been trying to engage in a conversation with her, communication, but it just hasn't happened. And then you, she said, and every time you talk, it's sexual. But I don't know whether she knew or cared that I was there. She obviously never knew I was sleeping.
See, I said to her earlier, we were talking, and I said, I know who's voted for me. And I just said it to Dennis. After Jodie, I knew I was going to be out. And that's cool.
But that doesn't wouldn't make any sense.
Why not? They've got to vote for somebody. Are you kidding me? Do you think they'll let a black or an Asian girl ever, or guy, win this thing? Are you out of your tree? Think about it, darling. Never.
We're not going to remember
that.
You're saying we would not.
This country. Oh, please. No. Don't even get me going on that. So you got don't.
You in this country, this is a different honey. They
would never. They'd fall over themselves before they let something like that.
Shit, dude.
A two black Americans, a male or female, would never win.
Don't
this
matter.
Show.
Black, I'm Asian. They won't.
We're Asian.
Me?
So.
Are you out of your mind? They'd be up in arms. Oh my God, what the hell just happened here? They'd be up in fucking arms. I've been seeing it from day one.
Right, that's what I said.
So basically, we're all in here. Okay, this is it. Here's the show. We have something for everyone.
What did I tell you I wasn't here for?
Nothing.
I said I'm here
just
for
to
color.
Cause havoc with
for color.
Oh, for color.
I said I'm here
to
for
add color.
Color. Well, not the race thing, but just add color.
No, I don't think it's a race thing.
Just add color. That's it.
Eleven a.m. Preston, Maggot, Tracy, and Rula are in the kitchen.
According to Faria and Dennis, if you're a minority, end quote, you don't stand a chance of even winning on this show.
It's turned into a race thing now, see?
But do you know what I'm saying? And the reason why I found out that conversation is because I wanted to ask you, Rula. I was awake, actually, I was already awake, and you, I don't know what you were saying before, but you were saying that you and I have not engaged in a conversation or communicated, and Dennis, because every time he speaks, it's about sex. And I just wondered if you can explain that to me, because I don't know. Because I thought I did have a chance to win. But according to Dennis and Freya, because of the fact that I'm a female, I'm an American, and my skin is brown, I don't stand a chance.
I think that's silly.
Well, I have
silly
to say, that never came into... The only thing that I envy you both for, you and Dennis for, is the fact that you have this very strong hobby of the physical exercise. It is true that up until now, you and I have not had the opportunity
to
have a proper conversation,
exactly.
Which I feel I've had to a certain degree with everybody else in the house.
Right.
Now, what the reason for that is, I don't know. And that was all that was intended.
You know, Faria is considering herself a minority, and she's nominated, and Dennis is minority, and he's nominated. They both feel that you don't have a chance on this show, in this country at all, on a show like this.
Michael's gay, Maggot's Welsh, do you know what I mean? You could say it's...
In the same way, I could say I don't stand a chance because I'm way too old for the vast majority of the public who watch this programme. We were all put in here for a reason.
But if you all walk over and go right into where Faria is and go walk over there and talk to Dennis where he is, and if you ask them what they were saying to me, they'll explain it to you. So my thing is they're feeling that they don't stand a chance.
How can they not stand a chance this week? Not one of you was
nominated, if that was the question.
You haven't been nominated both weeks, so that's you out of it. Dennis has only been nominated once. So we were racist this week, but we weren't last week.
No, wait. I didn't say it. They said it, and I just asked the question, well, wait a minute. If you two are nominated and you two are both minorities, what chance do I stand? Dennis said you're...
Well, you haven't been nominated.
I know.
How else do you explain that you are American and you're dark-skinned and yet you haven't been mentioned? Right, if there was any truth in that, then you would have all three been nominated from the beginning.
I mean, this
I can't believe this has even come up. I think it's ridiculous.
I'm disgusted.
I'm just really offended.
I nominated one black person because that black person was attacking constantly the other black person.
Yeah.
That's how non-racist it is. Did you hear that?
But I nominated... I'm probably not meant to say it, but I nominated two black people.
Yeah.
But it It didn't. That thought hadn't even crossed my mind for a second.
Yeah.
That's fucking ridiculous.
Unbelievable, wasn't it? Anyway, tonight, you decide if Dennis, Faria or Pete get the boot from the Big Brother house. To evict Dennis, call 09011-32-33-02. To evict Faria, call 09011-32-33-03. That's 09011-32-33-03. To evict Pete, call 09011-32-33-08. That's 09011-32-33-08. Or you can text the name of the housemate you want to evict to 84444. Line's going to close in 19 minutes. And join me after the break when we welcome TV royalty to the house. Okay, welcome back to Celebrity Big Brother. Now, the housemates have nominated Dennis, Faria and Pete to face the public vote. And that means you have the power to decide which one will be on their knees begging for mercy in about 15 minutes' time. So to evict Dennis, call 09011-32-33-02. It's 09011-32-33-02. To evict Faria, call 09011-32-33-03. That's 09011-32-33-03. To evict Pete, call 09011-32-33-08. That's 09011-32-33-08. You've got 14 minutes left to vote. But first, ooh, more from yesterday's action. And what's the best thing that could happen when an argument's completely raging in the house? Richard and Judy pop out. Pop in, sorry.
...11:55am. Dennis is in the living room. Most of the other housemates are in the kitchen.
Far from my perception of there being any racism against Dennis, in fact, people have made huge allowances for his aggressive, rude and vulgar behaviour.
We all have.
That they would never have from a white man. Never. If he had been at the table saying some of the things that Dennis has been saying, making some of the gestures that Dennis has been making, handing out his plate without saying a word and expecting somebody to get him food and put it on it, he would have been out of here by now. If, as you say, and I didn't nominate Dennis, in fact, the opposite.
We're not supposed to talk about this.
We can't talk about this.
We can't talk about nominations. We can talk about the rest.
A man who talks all day and all night about the size of his cock and who he's going to have sex with and who he's had sex with and so... You don't put up with that kind of conversation from anybody. But we have put up with it from Dennis because we see something else in him too.
So then maybe that's why he was obviously nominated in the house, you know?
Well, that's a valid reason, but that's got nothing to do with black America.
Oh gosh, you know what, Michael? I hope that it just, I feel right now at this point that you're blowing it out of proportion.
I'm blowing it out of proportion?
You seem very angry right now.
Yeah, I am.
Why are you very angry right now?
Well, go figure.
Because see, right now, I feel like I don't want to say anything at this point on. I feel like I can't. I feel like I shouldn't open my mouth. So I'll just be cute little happy fun Tracy. And that'll be good.
Dennis has to speak, basically.
Dennis does have to speak.
If he so chooses.
He's
a big grown-up man.
Of course.
And he has to speak for himself.
I think he's upset that he's been nominated. And, okay. But I said it's just a game.
Kafka. You know? Everybody
Kafka-esque. Yeah, okay, a little bit, but I'm to be very honest. But
you want to come over? We've got a discussion going on here about apparently a statement that was made to do that black Americans can't win on this program because of racism.
Who said that?
That's what Tracy is. We've been talking for the last half hour about it.
Really?
You know, we're all sitting there going, well, you know, we consider that outrageous. And I do, certainly. I don't think that's fair, Dennis. You know? I don't think it's fair to have a discussion about the third party when the third party is not involved.
I guess you're right, huh? Oh, this is funny.
whether it was from me not making the effort or her not making the effort, that we hadn't actually had any real communication on it.
Yeah. And then I said to her, I said, go and ask for them.
And she did.
Yeah.
And that was clarified, except that it was all put on the basis of...
Can we just...
Ten...
Dennis.
What? Don't me?
No. Call and speak when you want.
Hey, Tracy. You want some salt on your shoe?
Dennis, so what have I created now?
Besides the fact you say with this, that this, the British people are racist and all this bullshit, this. What have you created?
I created a TV episode.
I think you just did that. Well, you started some, finish it.
I didn't mean to.
Let's finish it.
I was just saying how, because you were saying how...
Wait, I was saying? I didn't know my
Wait, Dennis, the whole thing started is when I went in to talk to you and Faria about a comment that Rula made...
Who's doing all the talking? Did Faria open her mouth and said that shit? I didn't say that.
Dennis, did you or did you not say that you were here for color?
I said to add color to this fucking show.
Dennis, you said that there was no way that, you know, a black person could win the show.
Wait. Hold on. So you go throw me on the bus.
Isn't that what you said?
Hold on. You go throw me on the bus and say, you know what? Do it. I'll say that I said it because she said it.
I don't want you to say that you said it. You said it, Dennis.
I said I said it.
Isn't that what you said?
I said that. I started that whole conversation already. Did I start?
No, I did. I went in there and I was asking.
And you said that I said it. I said because I'm on this show because of color. You said that. And you said that I said because there's no way a black person going to win this fucking show. Did I say that first or did she say it first?
No, I said that.
She just said she said it. I didn't say that.
I said it first.
Please, can we have some more? Michael?
Oh, look. I'll tell these motherfuckers what the fuck to do with this goddamn show and these motherfuckers. I don't give a shit.
Yo.
I don't give a shit. You want to start it? I'll finish it for you. Dennis. I'll go in right now and tell you about fuck the fuck up all of them.
Dennis, I wasn't trying to start anything.
I will. I don't give a shit.
I was just trying to...
I ain't gonna never see these motherfuckers again.
I guess
I don't give a shit. I'll tell all these motherfuckers the fuck off. I don't give a shit. I don't live here. I don't give a fuck. When you want to start some shit, go out there and finish it. I'll make people hate my ass, too. I don't give a fuck.
Dennis, I wasn't trying to start anything.
Why don't you go out there and tell them, motherfucker? Go out there and tell them. Go out there and tell them.
I did. I did.
So why the fuck everybody's getting all upset there?
It's a bit part of this, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
It just makes me fucking crazy. Yeah. Dennis keeps pointing at us and making some thing about how we're all motherfuckers.
But, you know, consider if that same...
We ain't mother...
You are.
Let them sort themselves out. And we might have to continue this, hopefully, and get on with the rest of the day.
Hey.
PM. Most of the housemates are at the dining table. Faria and Dennis are in the bedroom.
In America, you put certain people in there, you add colour to the spice. That's what I was...
Yes, but you might have said that in that context, but it didn't come out that way on there. I assumed you were talking about your colour.
Did you hear me say, I'm talking about my skin colour. I said the colour that adding, you know, charisma, spice to it. You didn't hear me say that, right?
No, I didn't hear you say that.
If you think because I'm black on this show, no, it's nothing about that. Nothing about that. Where are you going now, bastard?
Well, that's what... Don't talk to me like that!
See, now she get pissed. So, come here.
Who's shouting in there?
Faria.
What's happening now?
A little shouting. Okay.
Hello?
What's going on in this fucking house, man?
Maybe I feel bad a little bit about being... nominated, but it's okay.
Well, that's okay. I don't feel bad to do this though, but you keep stress. Like I said, honey, I could break anybody in this motherfucking house down, but you were okay. Well, we'll find out. You just said it right there. I think that you feel bad because you got nominated, I think you feel worse because you know who did it.
Yeah, I do know.
That's probably why you feel so fucked up, because you know who did it. Like I said, you've been keeping your composure out of everybody. Said it to you earlier, you keep your composure, but now all of a sudden, now it's getting to you, but now all of a sudden.
It's getting to me because I know that I can leave soon. That's why it's getting to me.
Well, you can't fool me.
What's carrying on in there?
Honestly?
I was going to.
They've got other personal business that has nothing to do with anybody else.
This is personal. What's going on in there?
Yeah.
Like I said, I'm probably the strongest person here. Like I said, you can say something to me, it won't even faze me. I don't give a fuck.
I'm sorry, I think you're wrong. I think you're blooming sensitive.
To what? To what?
Well, why did you get rallied up down there?
Well, you better ask Tracy. You don't know me that well.
Probably not.
You don't know me that fucking well. I can do this shit.
I don't claim to know you that well.
I can do this shit like
equally
a
motherfucker. Can't claim to know me.
I'm going to say what's on my mind directly, what's going on. And I got a right to say that shit no matter what the fuck. Just like fucking Joyce do. But every time, what you say, Joyce, he's respectable. He's this. He says his fucking mind, but nobody says anything about that. But hey, when I say it, well, people respect it.
Yes, because, hang on, it's the colorful language you happen to use.
I don't give a shit about you fucking hate all this, the big words and shit like that. I don't really give a shit.
You don't need to use big words, but you don't have to swear each time.
You better bring it up, because I will.
PM. All of the housemates are at the dining table.
What are we addressing?
We're addressing...
This is what we're addressing.
What was said in there, and that Tracy perhaps misunderstood and said that Dennis had said something. It was actually I who had said it, and I said it here, and I said, I don't think it's possible for a black or an Asian to win Big Brother. I said, are you kidding? I said it, and then Dennis agreed. I said, why are you here? And he said, to add colour. And I assumed he was talking about skin colour, and he wasn't. He was talking about adding spice and entertainment. I was just trying to clarify that with him. I do feel a little hurt that I've been nominated, but I'm sorry. I just do. And it's fine, don't do that. I'm fine, and I'm sorry if I get upset, but I've tried to be who I am, and I haven't tried to be anybody else. And I'm sorry I'm upset. I'm really angry at myself for being upset, and I didn't need to be upset. But it has hurt me. But I'm absolutely okay with leaving, so don't... Sorry. Emotional crap.
You on the rag?
I told you, it was post.
Fucking pre and post, it's an endless cycle.
5:05 PM. Earlier today, Big Brother asked housemates to nominate one person who they consider to be articulate and calm under pressure to take part in the shopping task. The housemates chose George. Big Brother has told George that he'll be playing You Say We Pay live on Richard and Judy.
Hello.
A game where Richard and Judy must correctly guess what contestants are describing. For each correct answer, he'll win £20 for the housemate shopping budget.
And he's waiting for us now, so first of all...
Hello, George.
Now, we have to say to you, George, we cannot give you or the other housemates listening to this now any feedback at all as to how this extraordinary programme that you're on is playing out here. We can't say anything about that, OK?
I know.
OK, well, the whole of the rest of the housemates are watching and listening to this, and they're begging you to do well, because they're hungry.
Very good luck, George. You've got 1 minute, and your time starts now.
A piece of meat on a skewer.
Kebab.
The former dictator of Iraq.
Saddam Hussein.
A very, very odious little insect that crawls out of dead people.
Maggots.
Love it.
A ditzy blonde who... was once on Rowan and Martin's Laughing and has gone on to a great...
Goldie Hawn.
Transvestite, very colourful singer.
Who else?
A bit of a chameleon.
Oh, Boy George.
Boy George.
Our closest living relative. The highest of all the
chimpanzees.
Primates. Chimpanzees.
Gorillas.
Last one at a time.
The hero of Baywatch, the man in Baywatch.
David Hasselhoff. You've got £140 for the housemate.
Well, you've done really, really well, actually. I'm really impressed by that.
So just as we can't tell you anything about what's happening out here, and
I think we can say there's a lot happening out here about your programme. You can't tell us anything at all about what it's like in there for you.
I think I'm forbidden to do so, and we're so hungry here, I don't want to take any chances.
Okay.
I don't blame you. Give our love to all your housemates.
Yeah, give our best to all the housemates. Tell them we love them all, and we're thoroughly we're watching it every night. We really are enjoying it.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Bye,
well done, George.
Well
you played that beautifully. Well done. Bye.
George, you're
well
fantastic.
Done, George. Yes.
Well, that's £140 we've got.
Well, yeah. What were you getting per question? How much?
£20 per question.
All right.
Oh. So we've got 7 in 1 minute, which is good.
I think it was a bit unnecessary. Ruler said you should have got 12. Easy.
You lying Arab.
140.
Oh, sorry, that was racist.
Is that our budget?
Oh, let's open
not,
that.
Not
one
really
again.
The company. Not really the company for that racist joke.
Is that our budget?
Ruler. Now, did you notice that both Preston and George discussed nominations today? Did you? I feel a punishment coming on. Okay, time's up. Lines are closed. Not even Sir Jimmy can fix it now. In just 4 minutes, I'll be giving Dennis, Faria or Pete your verdict. I'll see you then. Welcome back to Celebrity Big Brother. It's been 14 days since our celebrities walked through those infamous doors. And now one of them is about to be kicked right back out. So I'm now going to talk to the house. I love this bit. Big Brother House, this is Davina. You are live on Hi. You are live on Channel 4. Please do not swear. Dennis, Faria, and Pete. The lines are closed. The votes have been counted and verified. And I can now reveal that the second housemate to be evicted from the Big Brother House is... Faria.
Thank you.
I'm all right.
Sorry, I'm actually really jealous. I bet you got the whole team to go through. All second division. Shit. Oh, Faria, drain them all.
See you soon.
Seriously, you look.
Faria!
Faria!
Yes!
Okay, you've got 30 seconds to say your goodbyes because I'm coming to get you!
Thank you.
Goodbye, Faria.
Bye, Dennis. Okay.
See you later.
Bye.
Good.
Bye.
Good crap.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you all. Love you. Thanks. No.
15 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Faria, you have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house. Faria, you have been evicted. Please leave the Big Brother house.
bad out here, actually. You've just given Faria her second public sacking. Join her after the break. Quite a rip-roaring reception in here, but it was quite heavy out there. There were parts of the crowd that were quite heavy.
Yeah.
What was that like? Was it what you were expecting?
Yeah, I did expect it. I'm not under
any. But it's quite difficult because I don't. You can't hear me at the moment. Hang on, let me just go and grab them. Oh, we can't hear Faria. Hang on, we're just going to swap over your microphone.
Thank you.
It's not your fault. Hello. It's ours. Can we hear Faria now?
Can you hear me?
We can hear Faria. That's quite frustrating is that I feel that you've been on a real journey in that house because I think public perception of you was quite poor when you went in there. Mm-hmm. And as time's gone by, it improved, and then you got nominated this morning.
Yeah.
And the problem with that was when, because you were upset, you talked about the great British public.
Yes.
Never voting for an Asian or a black person to win.
I understand.
And I think actually the great British public got really worried or sort of upset about that. And
yeah, they must have done. I did reflect on that later on and thought perhaps that was the case. And no sooner as something leaves your mouth than you think.
Because you do say things in the heat of the moment.
Yes, I have.
But not just in, like before, but in the house as well.
You do, kind of,
you think
you've got
it
to understand
and you say
something,
it.
But you've got to understand something. You're under such pressure.
Yes, yeah, like
and people
pressure.
Looking as a viewer, you sit there and you think, oh, please, you know, they've got it all good and everything else. But the build-up and the psychological aspect that comes through, and when you're sort of, you're confined in a way. Yes, we're very lucky and we, you know, we're staying in sort of a luxurious place and we have a pool and blah, blah, blah. But there is the other side where we were deprived of food for the past sort of couple of days. And Michael was so clever in the kitchen, putting things together.
Hello,
bees.
Excuse me, Mrs. Kitchen Person.
Oh, well,
hello.
Yeah.
Hello. No, listen, I've digressed, because really what I need to show you at this part of the interview, I'm sorry to say, are the nominations.
Yes.
With anybody, it's like, I don't want any confrontation, and then she'll get angry, and she's got it all pent up inside.
She failed her task.
She doesn't really have that much to say on the kind of issues that are generally discussed in the House.
Any surprises?
Not really, no. The two that I suspected was, and the third one, I did suspect George, actually, but I shoved it out of my mind because I thought, oh, maybe not.
So Michael and Maggot were a bit of a surprise.
Absolutely. No. Michael and Maggot were absolutely spot on, actually. I knew they had, and I felt that because there was a shift in the way they were with me. And just things...
You can kind of tell when somebody walks back in the room sometimes because they can't make eye contact.
Yeah, they can't make eye contact, and he didn't.
Being nominated was quite upsetting. Was that a surprise?
Not really a surprise. I was just hurt by it, actually, to be honest with you, because I didn't think I'd... And the thing, again, you know, you're forced into this sort of environment where you can't help but pick up on any tiny little minute, you know, you breathe wrongly, or you've got your dress stuck in your knickers or something, and then, boom, oh, God, you know, heaven forbid, let's hang her, because that's the way it works in there.
Mm.
And it's not... perhaps general perception, but it is in the house.
Mm.
So you're under such confinement, and it's
and
almost you're pushed into
like,
a corner.
Did you nominate me?
Yeah,
did you?
Yeah.
Now, during your time in the house, there was a lot of talk about celebrity status and of the housemates and motivation for being in there. And then Big Brother set this task where you all had to stand up and say what you were famous for.
Mm-hmm.
Let's have a look.
Oh, God.
The reason I'm famous is in July 2004, I was involved with the England coach and was exposed in the News of the World for having an affair with him. However, I was actually infamous for that. I am actually famous now for being in Big Brother. I hope that you will understand and take from this show what you've seen so far, the way I am, and not from what was written about me.
Bravo!
George is in politics. Yeah. Dennis is a world famous basketball player. Mark, you know, Michael Barrymore, you know, famous for entertainment. Yeah. And you know, then there was you, and I know you feel uncomfortable with why you were in there. How hard was that task?
It was very hard because you're talking about people who are actually talented in there. I wasn't in there for a talent. Shut up, you lot. So, I know what you're thinking. So, you know,
that is quite a talent.
Oh yeah. Well, anyway, moving on. But I just thought
I want
that.
Some lessons, actually.
Okay. We'll just talk about this later.
Okay, later.
But it was very difficult at the time, and putting myself in that situation where I knew that everybody else had something to add to this.
But you were very unashamed about it, and I kind of appreciate that, really.
But what did you want me to do? I mean, hang my head down and...
Well, you know what other people might have done. You're just... I don't know.
I had to be...
Listen, are you happy with your celebrity?
I don't see myself as one, though. Well, I am
now. You don't see yourself as a celebrity?
No, not at all.
Come on.
I've never seen... Ask anybody that
knows me. Well, famous,
then.
Are you happy with your fame?
I am infamous.
Are you happy with that?
No, not really. I have been infamous. But, you know, I'm famous now because I've been on this.
Now, listen. I want to talk to you about Dennis. You so fancy him. Come on.
No.
Come
on. No.
Hang on, Nicola.
I like him. No, he's a nice guy.
Come on.
He's a really nice guy.
The Rod. Come on. Do you fancy him?
Do I fancy him?
Yeah, do you? A little bit? Would you go out on a date with him?
Yeah. Maybe.
Do you think you'll see him when he gets out?
Yeah, probably. Maybe. I don't know, honestly.
Okay, well, let's just have a quick look at what we saw.
He's quite a nice guy. But I don't fancy him.
I like powerful men, and I do get attracted to them.
Rodman, you make me laugh!
When he used to play for the Chicago Bulls, I think, wow.
Amen. About a boy.
He's a very sweet guy. And he's quite understanding if you sit and talk to him.
To be mad about a boy.
No one ever knows.
The sleepless nights I've ever had. About a boy.
I just love a bit of romance in the house, and you gave me just a flicker, and thank you. Now, listen, do you think Dennis fancied you?
Yes. Yeah.
Not at all.
Oh, come on. He was thrusting and licking his lips and twiddling his nipple doodahs, and he was so frisky. Now, listen, quite odd when, obviously, there's a little spark happening, and then you nominated him. Where did that come from? It was so left of centre.
I honestly didn't know who else to nominate, that's why.
Really?
Yeah, and because he'd had that spat with me in the morning, which was really stupid, but that was the only reason I could find for doing that, and foolish or whatever it was, but I honestly didn't... I told you, I nominated myself at first. Oh, you didn't know this,
but... you can't do that.
No, I know, but what do you do when you when you just like everybody in the house? You all get on as a team. Everybody's, you know, sort of pulling together.
But you don't nominate the bloke you fancy. That's what you don't do. That's like the kind of...
Well, how do you know I really fancy him?
I just... Hello?
I'll stop! Okay. He's a nice guy. He's a really nice guy.
And I'm a nightmare a side with to my him. Mates. You just have to go with me.
You
sorry.
You are a nightmare.
Yeah.
There was a side to him I saw when we were doing the art thing today. Which you may
a softer
see later.
Side.
Yeah, much softer.
A different, but you, I think, actually, in that house, you extracted more from Dennis because you just didn't let him get away with stuff that he normally gets away with.
Yeah.
And actually, when he was with you, he came out of his shell so much more. I mean, we saw a different side to Dennis when he was with you.
Mm.
Anyway, listen, finally, I want to sort of sum up and talk about you, for real. So what have you learnt from your time in the house?
I've learnt that I have some anger within me that I need to perhaps deal with in some way, and I will address those things once
stabbing
I'm out.
Pillows is quite good.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Is that what you do?
So what are you angry about? quickly change the subject there.
Skillfully move away.
I really don't want to go down the whole boring thing of what happened to me before, but it was only because of the people who betrayed me. Those are things that made me angry.
But you know what? You've got to let it go.
Yeah, I know.
Actually,
I know.
Just let it go. Mm. I think this programme is quite good for you to sort of go from here and move on. Mm. Not trying to be a psychologist or anything.
No, it certainly is. That's what it's taught me here. But it also makes me realise internally that there are some issues I need to address. Yeah.
Was it what you expected?
No, particularly the psychological aspect of it.
Right.
I didn't understand that bit at all. It sort of takes you for six completely because of all the sort of things that you put under the tasks, the sort of pressures of having no food in the house, and then everyone going crazy because they can't smoke or drink or whatever. Like, it's like a huge thing, you know? And then perhaps those things are taken out on you in a roundabout way, you know?
Yeah.
And you do feel those things.
Yeah.
And the fact that, you know, Big Brother plays a few games with your mind.
Well, yeah.
Well,
we've got
that's
to.
The whole idea.
Come on, that's the fun. Yeah, sorry. Now, so do you think, and this is... I'm not going to apologise for it. Do you think Sven might have voted to evict you or not?
I don't think he gives a toss, really, does he?
Come on!
I don't think he gives a toss.
Nancy? Yeah. She would have done, wouldn't she? Yeah.
It's true! Yeah, right.
That's probably why you're here. What did you enjoy most about your stay?
The laughing and the singing.
Oh,
we all got
on
so well.
That was
so singing
brilliant.
Away. It was really good fun, actually. And when you do that, when you know some of the songs from back in my day, so it is a lot of fun to join in with all that.
And who do you want to win now that you're out?
I think Chantel.
Wouldn't that be so funny? Yeah. A non-celebrity winning celebrity Big Brother.
I mean, come on, she so deserves it.
Okay, and she should definitely release a single with Candy Floss, right?
Yeah, because it's mental.
Mental. Listen, Freya, thank you.
Thank you.
And you were a great housemate. You lasted almost 2 weeks in the house. Well done.
Yeah.
It's very good.
It's all right.
And here are your best bits.
It's the mentest thing I've ever done.
She's living in a famous man.
I got involved with someone that wasn't married, and I wasn't married. So what's the big bloody deal?
I have an issue with her telling stories about it to get famous.
I'm sick of being bloody judged all the time.
Hang her, kill her, slice her.
I read about your blowjobs.
If you hate me, I will show you how to brain me into something new.
She's always right there, cooking, cleaning.
She can cook her ass off. She's a great cook.
What are you cooking, Mama?
Being a piss in someone's tea.
At least that way you can walk away and say, I pissed in your tea, you fucker.
Are we having tea?
You're going to have spinach every 15 minutes.
Does it hurt?
Keep the trolley with you at all times.
Trolley.
You just have to take a tiny morsel of one leaf.
I know, it just feels sick. I'll do it, yeah. Let's go around. I don't want the camera to see me cry.
Every time we have the spinach delivered, she does it.
I like powerful men, and I do get attracted to them.
There's a facade that he's just rough and everything, and he's not. He's quite a nice guy.
Oh, I say.
Yeah, I'll take notes of that.
I was involved with the England coach. However, I am actually famous now for being in Big Brother, for which I thank you.
Whose tea did you pee in?
No, it wasn't Sven's. No.
That wasn't it. Okay.
It was an old boyfriend.
Okay.
Bloody well deserved.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, for Freya. So, Freya is out
tomorrow morning at 8. And join me at 5 past midnight tonight on Channel 4 when George and Preston get punished live. I'll see you then. Good night.
She was awfully fast, though. Yesterday she cried. The dust settled today. Next thing, she's out. It probably flung a suitcase at her. Down the ramp after her, panties and dresses everywhere.
Where's he going?
I didn't. She said to me she didn't mind going.
Well, I think she might have.
I think she did mind going.
Yeah, I think that's more of just what you say, isn't it?
But she knew that she was going.
Yeah, she seemed to know that for sure, didn't she?
She told me about a dream she had last night.
Yeah, I'd go where I was like to see at the time and all stand up and just say thank you very much and take a bow, but it doesn't work like that.
It doesn't work like that.
No, that's what it's all about. You've got to remember it's a game.
I know, that's it.
Well, I get so deep in analysing what was showing what. What does it matter? It's not important.
What would happen then if the internal
about
votes...
That? I mean, that's worrying about...
Oh, no, we had an example.
That's worrying about ego.
Of two icons being amongst...
I'm getting worried about, you know,
the
how you're perceived.
But that was with three choices.
You just do your part and that's it.
Well, it would have been a more difficult contest.
Play your part, right?
Yeah. Two nominees.
Yeah. Yeah.
If it had been beat against Dennis, that would have been a more difficult contest.
Very difficult.
I'd have just worn shorter skirts.
Yeah. I don't even bother analysing it or working it out. Never after. But that doesn't say people can't do that.
How do you solve a problem like diarrhea?
Well, that's been an idea. You sleep on that side by yourself.
So the question lies in your hands. Who did you vote for? That's the question right now. Who did you vote for?
Yeah, you're not allowed to say.
But I'm going to say it though. Just got to get you wondering. Who did you vote for?
Now?
No. Then.
I can't tell you.
I know, I'm just saying, just gotta keep it in your head.
I did, I do keep it in my head.